All right. Oh, man. Well, so far looks like there's no hope here for the Chevelle. Still can't get it to run right like it was before that last car show. But anyway, did have a decent burnout yesterday with it. I'm going to go digging into the distributor today. I'm going to finish up the C10 out there. Hook up the water pump. I got that hooked up and hook up the alternator. And yeah, show you some of the shit problems I was having with that. This boat, I had a hell of a time getting this boat out. I got the head all fucked up on it. I cleaned it up. It was so rusty. I mean, it just wouldn't come out. And I got the head rounded off. It's supposed to be a 9/16 head on it. But my 9/16 rounded it off. Because it wouldn't come out. And so I took a 14 millimeter 6-point impact socket and I beat it on there with a hammer. And then I got it loose with a breaker bar. So I went yesterday and I got new bolts. Brand new grade 8 bolts at a little place called Surplus City. And I went ahead and bought two of them bolts because I only paid $1.65 for both those bolts. You know, and there, it was supposed to be, well, it was supposed to be $3 a pound for the bolts, like $3.99 a pound for bolts in their hardware section down there. And it was real cheap like that. See, it's still kind of tight in there, but anyhow, it doesn't matter. I can get it in there, shoot a little bit of lube in there, lube in the hole, a little bit of lube in the hole. Boy, my workbench is a fucking nightmare. Jesus Christ. But anyhow, anywho's, if anything else, you'll see 20 here is running really good. It's running real good. And I haven't had any major issues with it. Went to the Lashbaughs car show there last night. Got a little bit of footage from that for you. Wasn't a real big turnout for that. A lot of it was the same shit from last year and some of the other shows. I took the C20 down and just bullshitted some people. That's about it. The Chat and Chew, they had their car show last night, and Pen Alps up here in Grantsville, they had one also last night. And if I would have known the one at Pen Alps was last night, I would have went to that one instead. I washed dishes there. That was like my first job that I got paid an actual paycheck and paid taxes on. These other jobs I had around here was helping these farmers put their hay in. And I made money under the table at those places. And when I worked at the hen house down here, that was paid. It was under the table pay. But that was like the second place I went to work. And the thing is with that, I was just a kid back then working them places and paying taxes just I didn't really, it wasn't a big deal to pay taxes, you know, and I didn't have to worry about it because, you know, back then the government didn't come down on you as hard as what they do now when you don't pay your taxes. You don't pay taxes now, they want to put you in jail forever. You know, especially if you're working stiff like myself. You make one little mistake on your fucking tax form and they want to bury you under the fucking jail for some reason. You know, but if you're a rich guy or a politician, well, they're all rich people now anyway. But if you're a rich politician, they, you know, oh, it's all right. It's okay. Don't worry about it. You know, we'll just have these working motherfuckers just pay your taxes for you. So just go ahead. Enjoy your flambé. Go ahead. You're in your baked Alaska. Go ahead. Enjoy yourself. Your caviar. Go ahead. Eat that. Yeah, there you go. What, sex scandal? Sex scandal with a underage intern? Oh, no, don't worry about it. It's okay. It's all right. We sex traffic from the border every day. Oh. So, oh, you're good. You're good. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. So anyway, oh shit. So, yeah, it was a decent show down there yesterday. It was all right. When I left in the C20 here, I lit the tires up. Just saying, it's a one tire fire, and then when it starts spinning, it just don't want to stop. So I was a melting that one tire on the fucking ground leaving down there. It sure does get everybody's attention when you do that shit. So went there, did that, and then I went and picked up dinner. And headed home here. But yeah, the mission for today is to get all this stuff back on the C10, get the alternator back on it, get the belts back on it. Oh, that heater hose is so crusty and hard as fuck on that thing. I don't know if it's going to seal up again or not. But I need to put the radiator back in it. Dump some antifreeze in it. I got some old radiator hoses here. I'm gonna get one of them and try it on there. Well, I have a couple here. I have a couple straight radiator hoses hanging in my window up here. Right here, below my Genesee sign or behind it. Have a couple old hoses I swiped from an employer that these were hanging over there in Morgan on the outskirts of Morgantown in the shop that we had over there. And they weren't going to fit no big truck, so I was like, because they was going to throw these away in the dumpster. And I was like, well, fuck. Those are all good hoses. I'll just take those. Because you never know when you might need one. You never know. I mean, people call me a pack rat, say I'm a fucking hoarder, whatever. But that stuff right there, you never know whenever you might need a part. And, you know, have a use for it. And I am in need right now. So anyway, everybody, I hung out my American flag too yesterday on the C20, and it drew some people in. They liked it. They looked at it. They read some of the stuff that's on the windows, and they laughed. I saw people laughing and stuff, and like the skeleton sitting in the bed, all that bullshit, you know. It's an attraction at times. I mean, the truck doesn't look bad, especially in certain times of the day, certain lights, it looks pretty damn good. Down there when I stopped to get my dinner, went to a place called Mario's to get some dinner. And I was coming back out to the parking lot to get in it to go home. And it just, it, the way the sun was hitting it in the evening there, it just, it looked so good. It would have been a really good opportunity to take a picture of it, but I didn't do it because I had my hands full. But yeah, it, yeah, fucking hands going numb here. But it was pretty awesome though. It was a good time yesterday. I didn't stay there real long. Oh, shit. But happy motherfucking Sunday. So, everybody, have a good one, and I'll see you on the next one, and like, share, comment, subscribe. Here is your fucking half-assed car show. Beware of Wife. Oh my. Pistol grip.
It's your 54?
Yes, sir.
Where'd you get that tack at?
I have had that since I've been a teenager, and that's been
fucking cool.
4 or 5 years ago.
4 or 5 years ago.
Actually, I have two of them.
Really?
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
I got a guy that is dying to buy that from me.
Wow.
It does not work. I thought they worked when I put them away many, many years ago, but it doesn't work, so.
Huh.
He collects them, is what he does.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, they're scarce anymore.
Huh. I guess I'll have to paint one.
There you go.
That's what I'll do. I'll just paint one. Then I'll lie to him and say, look what I bought. Look at that shit. One of a kind.
Yeah, who'd have thought back in the day, you know?
Yeah.